flawed, selfish, and indulgent. You can't like seeing that in me.
Hey, humans are also vulnerable, worthy of love, capable of change.
I wish I could see myself through your eyes.
You're perfectly imperfect, but that doesn't mean you're not a person of value. I see you. You just have to take responsibility for your actions, and maybe that'll give people a chance to see you too.
Thank you.
Anytime.
Spencer makes his own choices, and they're usually very bad choices, which is why he is now serving time in prison.
Only for 30 days?
Trina.
Okay, Spencer has done some stupid stuff.
Terrorizing his stepmother, terrorizing his stepsister, a child. No, 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 honey, that's more than stupid. That's boyish.
I told him that.
It's entitled.
I told him that too.
And frankly, it's criminal.
I let the prison sentence say that for me.
While Esme sets fire to Ava's car and leaves a memento of Ava's dead daughter by the wreckage,
Esme said that was Spencer's idea.
And you believe what Esme says?
I don't think anyone can believe that.
Which is exactly my point. Honey, if after all of that, Spencer can't see who Esme really is, I don't think he ever will.
I just can't help it.
Spencer still has the potential to be a good guy. Or at least sort of a good guy. He just needs to get away from Esme. Esme brings out the worst in him, and I can't stand it.
Then don't.
Sorry.
For what?
That I took it this far. And that I let you get caught up in it.
You could have stopped when you saw me at the gallery.
Trina, the sprinklers were already set to go.
Then you could have taken off your stupid mask. Do you know how scared I was? I thought you were gonna hurt me, or worse. So it's pretty obvious that at no point in your plan did you think of anyone else besides yourself.
That's not true.
Sure it is. There are so many ways you could have played it. You don't want me to see your face? Fine. You could have told me I wasn't in any danger, but you didn't because you didn't care. Because I was nobody to you.
Okay. See you in a month?
Not if I see you first.
So, Trina, I'm so glad to see my nephew chooses his companions so well.
I see you. It's not your problem anymore. doing the right thing.
You can hide in the dark, but the
I'm only pretending to stand by Esme until she slips up, until I have evidence that she's the one who filmed and posted that video of Joss and Cam. That she's the one who is guilty and not you.
So you believe Esme is just a pretense to trap her?
That's why I suggested that she move into Windermere. She thinks it's so that she'll stay safe from my Uncle Sonny, but really it's so that I can watch her and try to get evidence that she is the one who's behind the video.
You're doing this to help me. Why?
Because I'm falling in love with you.
Benzer carried a torch for you for a long time.
Why didn't he tell me?
Because in his boneheaded way, I think he thought he was protecting you. He figured if he was honest about his feelings, then Esme would make you suffer even more. And knowing Esme, shudder to think what she might have done.
And he told you all of this?
In a rare moment of openness.
Maybe I've been wrong about him.
Look, Spencer is a spoiled, entitled young man. And I am in no way vouching for him. But he does seem to genuinely care for you.
That's what was in the letter.
Probably.
He's reporting to Pinnonville today. That's where Nicholas is, at the PCPD, saying goodbye to Spencer. He wanted me to tell you that, by the way.
Oh, thank you. Great.
Do you think I should go see Spencer?
I think you're the only one who can decide that.
Trina, can we help you?
Am I too late?
Sorry, you missed him.